I must say that it was a very interesting experience. When I first arrived in Lisbon, it was a shock to see all the old buildings, all the old streets, because I was 5 and my parents decided to go to Angola. It was a shock, but at the same time, it was fascinating, because in Angola, I lived and I finished my high school in Nova Lisboa, a town that was 50 years old. For me, it was very interesting that I was looking at all these old buildings and trying to figure out how they were built. Afterwards, as a student, the main activity, the main technique taught at the Instituto Superior Técnico was reinforced concrete. So, to be a civil engineer at that time was working with reinforced concrete. Frankly, I was not attracted to do the same as the other contractors were doing. In Portugal, construction has a very large percentage of the internal product, much more than in average the rest of Europe. Portugal is a small country. There's no room for millions of structures. When I started STAP in 1980, my option was not to do new construction, not to do reinforced concrete, but to help extend the life of the existing structure. And my activity was to design and to solve problems in the existing structures. Sometimes brand new structures that had already some problems. There was a lot of work to do because reinforced concrete is not a stable material. After I start rehabilitating structures, rehabilitating buildings, old buildings would come across because Lisbon and many other towns have plenty of old buildings. They could not be approached with the same methods and the same techniques. So I decided to put on a new company which would deal mostly with masonry and timber structures. That's how Monumenta was started. Of course, in the beginning, I did several mistakes trying to use reinforced concrete in ancient buildings. And by the way, one of the problems that Palacio Mateus, where we stand, was precisely the use of reinforced concrete in the replacement of the roof. In the 70s, someone decided to replace the timber elements of the roof by reinforced concrete joints.
The joints have this shape. If the load increases, then the walls will tend to separate. Removing all the concrete, it was too intrusive. One of the things that we could do was to interlock the walls, to connect the walls at the corners so that they would be locked in that position. These walls are made of two leaves, but there was not enough connection between the two leaves, so the wall could be strengthened by applying what we call through type.
Vítor Cóias and STAP, his company, was one of the first companies that worked with us rehabilitation field with the different solutions that we tested, and there was always a concern that was not only test the new ideas or test the new solutions, but always try to develop some guidelines, because it's not easy to introduce to the engineers the new ideas if you don't have any guidelines to apply the solutions. And those are two examples of the tools that he created and we tested here in the university. This one is a tie to reinforce masonry walls. The problem he wants to solve and that we tested was to correct the direction of the drill. He created this inch system in order to avoid the problems with inclination. That element there, it's an anchorage for a tie to connect the walls together and the walls with the floors. His idea was to create some kind of toolbox with different tools that you can use in different situations.
After 2010, the recession was felt here in Portugal quite deeply. and the Portuguese authorities were pressured to simplify the legislation so that the international community of investors in real estate would be attracted in order to renew these decaying historical centers of the big towns. In a way, it was positive because there was this opportunity of using financial resources from foreign companies, but it was too simplified. For instance, in Lisbon, the city council decided that the facades of the buildings had to be preserved, but the interior of the buildings was not so important, and it was easy to allow for the demolition of interiors, the old structure, the gaiola structure, in the case of downtown Lisbon, and to renew completely the building inside. That was a tremendous decision, starting to change the authenticity, change the originality of these areas. Most of the downtown was in fact very degraded, and this new legislation enabled the new foreign investors to take hold of a lot of buildings for new uses, most of them related to low-cost tourism. Up to the 90s, the historical cities were being protected. There was a lot of limitations to alterations in the buildings. There were several studies done by OS Diagnostics to collect information for the city council about the buildings in Baixa Pombalina. In the 18th century, after the earthquake of 1755, a team of military engineers, they were trying to find ways of designing and constructing new buildings that would resist earthquakes. And the gaiola construction, three-dimensional structure, is the result of that effort. It's not a perfect solution, but it was a pity, it was a big loss that we were just throwing away that historical and cultural value. This building, we decided to maintain the existing structure and improve the existing structure through very low intrusive measures, maintaining the same functioning.
One thing that worries engineer Cóias was and is the reinforcement of old buildings, old masonry buildings that we have in our cities, in our towns all over the world, and that are particularly vulnerable in earthquake-prone countries.
We've made tests here at LNEC looking for solutions to strengthen them.
The idea was to assess the capability of advanced composites to increase the resistance of the wall panels. And in the end, we tested the whole building to a full-strength earthquake. The building as a whole withstood the test. It was really nice to see that some small parts of the building, you can see in the video, some parts fell down in a safe way, near the building, not far away from the building. All these steps were done with this particular scope in mind. We wanted to enable engineers and contractors to rehabilitate and to strengthen, in terms of structure, the existing buildings, particularly in historical city centers, without resorting to reinforced concrete. The project considered currently, as it is objective, the construction of a new luxury hotel, implying the total demolition of the interior of the block. Several citizens worried with the safeguard of the heritage, along with several associations belonging to the Forum do Património. They are prepared, in case such a project would be licensed, to go ahead and resort to the courts to prevent such loss. Dr. Cóias,
quero em nome do GECORPA dar-vos as boas-vindas a esta iniciativa. São já cerca de 45 as associações que subscreveram a declaração final do Fórum do Património. E isto é importante porque, como todos hoje já sabemos, os problemas, os nossos grandes problemas, não é o governo que os resolve, são os cidadãos.
We are now at Praça das Flores, one of the most beautiful and emblematic squares in historical Lisbon. People nowadays have much more awareness about the importance of the heritage, built heritage, including, and perhaps in particular, younger generations and there's an impact on the authorities, on the decision makers.
2017, more or less, there was a request to start a new building in this square. This very dissonant design of a very famous Portuguese architect, it didn't match at all with the rest of the square, and the residents were very unsatisfied with the design. They got in touch with the Forum do Património so that the project could be modified more in accordance with the rest of the square. The city council unfortunately sided with the promoter, so the residents along with the three associations decided to support legal action. Construction was already going on, but it had to stop because the judge accepted the request of the associations and approved the provisional measures. In the Tagus River estuary, south of Lisbon. In this area there are several of these tide mills. These are constructions which take advantage of the potential energy of the water as it flows back into the estuary. Unfortunately, most of these constructions have been abandoned.
You could not intervene in an existing structure without knowing exactly what was the problem.
We came here to see an example of the kind of service that OSI performs, the old company of Vítor Cóias. It's the service needed to diagnose before the intervention. To do that, we use some kind of non-destructive tests, like the small flat check that we used to evaluate the resistance of masonry.
In certain cases, like this one, the original structure was really very deteriorated. The city council decided in this case not to rehabilitate, but to reconstruct the original tide mill.